I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
Follow me.
This is not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Breeds. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Red Coast rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough. Putnam's just up ahead. You can't miss.
I don't care much for your excuses, gentlemen. We could be building on Bunker Hill. Breed is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their artillery!
Our orders came from men so divorced from the situation, we are compelled by reason to employ our own faculties to make a proper determination. Where the...
Bunker Hill! Good day, gentlemen!
General Putnam!
What?
I'm looking for John. I was told you'd be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside that city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Oh, that John might be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
I shall fly this flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral.
Thank you. He's off! You come back here, you! Bastards trying to get away! Coward! Get back here!
Thank you.
answer, and you tremble.
They need better numbers, you say. Better weapons, better training.
But I do not fear. And neither should you. For what they have in material, they lack in conviction and care. But not us. We have discipline. We have order. And most importantly, we have passion! We believe! So maintain vigilance. Conserve your ammo. Ensure a proper line of sight. And above all else, men, do not fire until you see the whites of their eyes. Dare. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston. As I said, he would. And set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom roaring down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit and wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you've proposed the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad as a March hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Cover! Why? Why did you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss. To explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
Who better we hold the strings than another?
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Sneak up on me like that. Why don't you just go off there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean? This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
Thank you.